discussing a very important topic of our language lab, that is phonetic symbols and transcriptions. But before moving to that topic, first of all, I would like to introduce you to the syllabus of our language lab, which consists of 5 topics, in which the first topic is phonetic symbols and transcriptions. The second topic is extemporate. The third topic is group discussion. The fourth topic is dialogue writing. And the fifth topic is listening comprehension. Now, on the basis of these 5 topics, we have devised 3 COs of our language lab, right? So, in this context, the first CO of our language lab is CO1, which tells that it develops better speaking skills through a theoretical and practical knowledge of English sounds through phonetics. And this CO falls under the category of our first topic, that is phonetic symbols and transcriptions, that after studying these 5 topics, what our students are going to gain. Now the second CO, it tells groom themselves in a holistic way through various activities like group discussion, listening comprehension skills, etc. Definitely, after completing these 5 topics, our students are going to groom up themselves, and there are going to be various topics like group discussions, listening comprehension. So this CO, it covers group discussions and listening comprehensions, which are the 2 topics of our language lab. The third CO is think out of the box and form dialogues for various life situations and develop confidence to speak in public. Very important CO this is, and definitely this CO will be covered through the topics extempore and dialogue writing. So accordingly, with the help of these the syllabus, we have devised these 3 COs, and we focus that after just going through all these topics, our students are going to definitely prove themselves in terms of listening, speaking, writing and reading skills. Apart from these 5 topics, we also have the content beyond syllabus with us, in which we have affixes and we also have synonyms and antonyms, right? So this is something content beyond syllabus. So in this class, we will be doing the first topic of our language lab, phonetic symbols and transcriptions. Now, what is phonetics, right? Many times when we Google any word, right? So we see that that word is also written in this format. So this is known as the phonetic transcription of that word. Now, whenever you go through a very good dictionary also, for example, the Oxford Dictionary, then also you'll get to see that the word is also there in the form of phonetic transcription. So what is phonetics? It is the branch of English linguistics which deals with the correct pronunciation, the production and transmission of speech sounds in the language. Right? Apart from that, what is phonology? It deals with the sound system of a particular language. Right? So this is a very major difference between phonetics and phonology, and it is often asked during your Y-levels. Phonetics is the branch of English linguistics, right, which deals with the correct pronunciation of speech and its sounds in English language. Right? Now, when we talk about English language, so in English we have 26 alphabets. Right? Now, these 26 alphabets are divided into 44 sounds. I'm just repeating, mark my words, I'm not talking about the alphabets. In phonetics, we majorly, you can say, focus upon the sounds which are coming. So, we have 44 sounds in the language. Right? Now, these 44 sounds, they are further subdivided into 20 vowel sounds and 24 consonant sounds. Right? Now, these, see, wherever, everywhere you can see that sounds are written. So, whenever we speak something, whenever we write something, we need to majorly focus upon the sounds that are coming. Now these 20 vowel sounds, they are further subdivided into 12 monophthongs and 8 diphthongs. Right? Now these monophthongs, they are also known as single vowel sounds. For example, T, ship, you can just see that only a single vowel sound is coming. T mein it is badi e ki matra which is coming. And ship mein it is choti e ki matra which is coming. So it is majorly about the single vowel sounds that we are talking about. The next is the diphthongs. We have 8 diphthongs, and diphthongs means double vowel sounds, right? For example, knife, shout. So, A and E, knife, A, E, shout, aum. So there are two vowel sounds which are coming here. So this is something about the sounds that we were talking about. Now when we talk about the sounds and when we are talking specifically about the vowel sounds, right? So in English, we have five vowels with us. A, E, I, O and U, right? And many times your teacher must have taught you that if there is a vowel sound, if there is a vowel, then what you need to put here, A or L, okay? Right? So, suppose, for example, the word is European. Definitely it begins with the vowel, which is E. But what the sound is coming here? The sound is not E which is coming, but the sound is year. And year is not a vowel, it is a consonant. So this is the reason that we are going to put here A. Right? It is not AND. If you are putting here AND European, then definitely it is going to be wrong because it is not a vowel sound. Right? It is a consonant sound. Take for example next, H-O-U-R. Now we don't pronounce, how we are going to pronounce this? We are going to pronounce it as R. Okay? Because H is silent here. And again what sound is coming here? R. R is a vowel sound. So we are going to put here AND. So this is the reason that on the basis of sound which is coming, we are going to put A or AND. And if you are going to follow the simple rule, definitely nobody can, you can never commit any mistake, right, in putting the A or AND. Now, you must be wondering that from where all these sounds, these vowel sounds, these consonant sounds are coming, right? So, this is just IPA, right? Now, this is an organization, this is an association which works on the transmission, on the production, on the reception of these speech sounds, right? Now what is the full form of IPA? There are two full forms of IPA. The first full form is International Phonetic Alphabet and the second full form is International Phonetic Association. And this is also a very common question which is asked during your Viva. Right? That what do you mean by IPA? What IPA stands for? What are the two full forms of IPA? So please keep all these things in mind. Right? So this is something about the organization which is working upon the production, transmission and reception of these sounds, right? Now, we were talking about these 44 sounds which are further subdivided into 20 vowel sounds and 24 consonant sounds, right? There are 12 monotones and 8 diphthongs. So, today we are going to talk about, I have a chart already prepared here which deals with these vowel sounds and the consonant sounds. Right? So, specifically if I talk about the vowel sounds, they are 20 in number, right? In which 12 are monotones and 8 are diphthongs. So, from year to year, you can see they are monotones, they are single vowel sounds, and here you are going to see that they are double vowel sounds, right? If I begin with this, now I with colon, it stands for badi E, right? And if you want to just pronounce any word, right? So you are going to see the phonetic transcription of that particular word, right? Now this is known as sheep. It is eagle, feel. So whatever the phonetic transcription of this word is written accordingly, you are going to judge that how you need to pronounce it, whether you should pronounce it as ship or sheep, right? So if there is I with colon, then definitely it is going to be sheep. Now this I, it represents chota E. Chota E means, for example, ship, busy, started, right? So these are various examples of I, which is chota E. This is the symbol of U, that is chota U. And suppose, for example, if you want to write good, right? So, good can be written as, see, first of all, whenever you transcribe any word into the phonetic transcription, you need to put the start line first of all, right? Now, it is G, G will remain as it is, right? Double O, now this is, we don't pronounce it as good, right? We pronounce it as good. Why we pronounce it as good? Because in the phonetic transcription, it is written as U, right? It is